Live again, Friday night, Winston Cup 88, for FSBRacing.com, your home for sim racing. This is Mel Minter Jr. along with my cohort in crime, the voice of FSB Racing, Greg Bernardo. What's up, Greg?
Well, Milty, it's going okay for me, maybe not so good for our racing server. A little glitch there on our first attempt at this race. We're going to go at it again, requalified, to be fair to everyone. But the more things change, Milty, the more they stay the same.
Or they stay the same.
Jeff Hale, Rick Johnson still on the front row. Newcomer Josh Elliker, though, stole a spot in the second row to go with Ryan Johnson. Rick and Sean Reap, who's having some connection issues there, Melty. As you see, I'm a little blinky there. He'll start in the third row there. So we'll keep an eye on that as well. And there's the rest of the field streaming out, a little discombobulated with the necessity of a restart here. But it looks like everyone was able to reconnect. Maybe no harm, no foul here, Milty.
Well, you know, 20-plus cars at the split speed of light. Just, you know, I mean, the technology that's involved in this is incredible. And sometimes it fails, you know, and it was early, and they were able to fire it up, and everybody was able to get back in, and hopefully we will have no more glitches.
Yeah, let's hope for the best here, as the pace car is off, and we're ready to re-give this a go. Friday night, Winston Cup Racing at FSBRacing.com. Jeff Hale, Rick Johnson, front row, and we'll see if we can get a nice stable restart. But we see again with Sean there completely gone, Milty, and now reappearing, and that's going to be some heart thumping times for his opposition.
Well, I experienced that in regularity. Turned out it was sound settings with my inferior rig I had before, but you never know with the internet. This stuff's going at the speed of light. You'll have to be mindful of that. And
yeah, and he's gone again, but there he comes back, and there's a wreck there. Maybe.
Jeffrey Stone around.
Oh, and Ken couldn't avoid him and punted him pretty good. And now Slim also into the wall hard, Milty. So, wow.
Oh, my gosh.
Keep an eye on that 25 car. He really hit the wall with that front, Milty, hard. And that could be an engine damage situation there.
Well, he's been making the charge, and he decided to start towards the back on this restart. And missing a race, he was definitely trying to make moves to improve his situation and try to get in the top three of the championship with a lot of races left to go still. But that's going to be a hard road to travel.
Yeah, we'll take a look at this incident again, Milty. And I don't know if that Sean with his connection difficulties there had any play in it, but as we are watching Jeff there, we see no Sean at all, and then he'll suddenly appear in front of Jeff, and I don't know if that spooked him a little or if there was actual contact, as we see if we can get a closer shot here. It actually just looks like he may have just lost it, and there's Sean reappearing. But as Jeff hits the wall and comes back across, nowhere for Ken to go, and just clips the 25 and sends him hard into the wall there, Milty.
Hard to see what he was seeing from his view. and cars disappearing and reappearing are very unsettling, and but it's hard to tell if that was the ultimate effect of that.
Right, and also
Is it?
subjective. What I'm seeing maybe from the broadcast perspective, Milty, may not necessarily be what he's seeing from his connection in his screen. So, like you said, it is a very unsettling feeling as we see Jeff coming into the pits, Slim going out, and we'll also keep an eye on Slim Jim now, Milty, to see if this car can if it's a wounded car now, or if the repairs can keep this car competitive.
We'll have to see what the 62 does too. He's pitting, no damage for him, but he might be thinking about parking it because I'm sure he's gotten word that that is an issue.
Yeah, absolutely. And if it happens while the race is in progress, the best suggestion is try to get to the outside, let everyone get by you, try to just tuck in as the last car in line, and see if that kind of settles in as the race goes on. But unfortunately, that was just the start of the race there, Milty, so really no time.
Yeah, with the server failure, and then I mean these guys have really—I mean that's part of sim racing. Part of any kind of racing, you got to really. Sean's bringing it back out there, and we'll take a look at his connection here and see how that goes moving forward. Obviously, if looks like it's stabilized, and he looks pretty good right now.
Yeah, and these things can ebb and flow, and there could have been something running in the system that he, was able to finally kick off, and things
Yeah, he's
of
pretty
that
tech
nature.
savvy.
So,
He is way more tech savvy than me. So,
yeah, and me.
he's, he would definitely prepare for this race without any of that kind of stuff happening. So, but it's the internet that can jump up and bite you.
And as we see the pace car,
Oh, wow,
pace car still has the lights on.
I
We'll
get
see if
breath
they
here.
shut off as we cross the start finish line here. And they do, so we'll be going back green, coming back around here. There's our top 10 running order on the screen. Jeff Hale and Rick Johnson continue to hold the 1-2 spot. Josh Elliker, Rick Bisconner, Ryan Johnson, and then Ken Hansen in the 9 car in 6th place. Then the 21 of Dennis Balsar, 99 of Pops hanging in there in 8th, 007 in ninth. That's
And
James
he dodged a
Jones.
bullet in that
Yeah,
first
we won't. That didn't happen,
Ilitch.
Milty.
Well, and that's the thing.
Don't give him the jinx.
It's the all-powerful wizard of Milty,
I bet rounding out that top 10, your favorite and mine, Milty. When he shows up, he's a threat to win no matter what the track. That's a 91, Ken Shea.
And that bumblebee car,
Yeah, it's an
the
unmistakable
iconic
car.
sim racing car throughout the sim racing community. When this guy shows up, he's a force to be reckoned with. He's a winner, He's also a great driver all the way around, and just like a lot of us throughout his career, is worked on his craft. One of the best short track drivers you'll ever see, but then has he gotten busy with the rest of this business here?
And we have a green flag out and get a restart here. Now it's with the single file restart. Let's see if these guys can settle in to some green flag racing here with Jeff Hale, Rick Johnson leading them out. Then Josh and Rick in that 43 STP ride. Sitting in fourth, Ryan Johnson fifth. I saw Isaac name on the server
Oh
earlier.
boy. Another blink for the 62 car. This is becoming an issue for Sean Reap here. really scaring the competition. Slim got way off there.
And of course, you know, Slim, of course, now is, what's the saying, Milty? Once bit. Oh, and Dan gets really high. He had to chase that car all the way from the wall, all the way down to the apron there, Milty. Great job by everyone around him, too, to give him the room he needed. But, man, that was a heart stopper right there for the 007. Ken Shea moving up. There's Troy Higgins, Guy Petra in that Ford Cobra 151 car.
And then, Ken
following them. Now, Ken was involved in that first incident, Milty. Let's see if his car's not wounded at all.
Yeah, Guy Petra and that Ford Cobra, you know, his man is, you know, the great Carroll Shelby, or I wouldn't be standing here telling you that.
And there's that.
Because he's running Z-Max.
And right now, all clear with the 62, but you see Slim way behind Milty. And now I'm wondering, is this caution or is this damaged car?
He's got damage, and he was spooked by the 62 blinking there, but
and there's the 101 car, Milty, and
Jeff Havoc.
Yeah, official membership locked in, I believe. So congrats on that to Jeff there in that 101 car. Now, can someone get him some paint already?
He's gonna have to work on that, and there's plenty of painters in this league. As he chases down the heavily damaged Jeffrey Stone in that 42 car.
And, you know, as a newcomer, Milty, my first season of actually trying to drive, I was trying to be an invisible driver. I would try to just stay in the back and just log.
Leo Kelly around on his own there, just got loose.
You're staying green too, Milty. With the one car there, not really any other cars around him, it's going to stay green. So kind of a bad break there for the 38.
Great run for Leo in the top five Tuesday night in the Super Speedway Series. But that was definitely a sticker pecker moment there. He's going to be checking his draws on that one.
And now obviously would like to see a caution, not of his own doing here, so he could make up that large deficit now that he's facing. But what I was saying right before that, Milty, is I just tried to get in the back there, and just I didn't care if I finished 20 in those days, Milty. Finishing 25th was actually a solid top 25 finish in this series. And if I told myself I just want to finish like 25th.
And well, this is pro sim racing, man. I mean, you got to be humble to who you're racing against. These guys are as good as anybody in the world, and in this game, in this mod, and this type of racing. I mean, that's totally objective, smart thinking.
And you know,
unless you're a prodigy and you come in and or a seasoned veteran from years of racing like these guys are, you know, I've won championships, I've won over 200 races in this league, and if I can get a top 5 or 10, if I get in one of these races, which I'd be lucky to do in this day and era, I would be real happy with that, you know.
Yeah,
thinking about when, you know.
I hear you on that. And right now, Jeff Hale continues to lead. Josh Elliker and Rick Bisconner have gotten by Rick Johnson for second and third. Rick back to fourth. Again, Rick, the master of every need of every track, Milty. He has a book. He knows what's in that book. He goes over it. He knows exactly what he needs to do and what lap he needs to be on and where his fuel can be to stay out one more lap. And the list goes on and on. And he's going to be comfortable where he wants to be. And right now that's fourth.
Yeah, in the points lead. And You know, he asked me to throw a shout out to his girlfriend, and I forgot her darn name. And I tried to get it before the start of the race, and sweetheart, I'm sorry, but she's right on there on another computer, right beside him. He was telling me after the race, supporting him. That's so cool, you know. I mean,
yeah, absolutely.
Us grown men, you know, there's a lot of places we could be on a Friday night. Myself, I could be in a bar, you know, and instead I'm here with my buddies, safe and warm, having fun. And, you know, when your woman, just like my wife, she supports me a lot.
Absolutely.
She knows what I could do if I was
absolutely
out there, you know, doing something else. And
sorry
I forgot your name, sweetheart, but Rick wanted to throw a shout out to you. And
yeah,
he don't say much, you know, so for him to do that, you know, he's a man of few words. His words are on the track, man.
And Jeff Hale continues to lead here. The field kind of breaking up just a bit here, so maybe settling in for a green flag run here.
Let's take a look at what this track is about. This is one of the original, like, seven NASCAR tracks. Been around since before you and I were even born. And very strange corners. Completely different. One and two and three and four. Kind of a flat spot in between three and four here as we go in car.
We'll go in car with the nine car here, Ken Hansen, right in the thick of things. And why don't you give us a few laps around Charlotte here, Milty?
This is just an unbelievable track to drive. You go in the one and two, they're tighter, but banked more here, so you want to get way out to that outside line. Well, actually, that's three and four, sorry. Now, one and two, be tighter here. Then you get a flat spot right in the middle here. We kind of let the car drift out a little bit, and then right up to the wall there. Just a little lift, and these cars is almost flat out by yourself, but you got a lift. No brake here. You see that? From the in-car, you're not thinking it's that much different, but it is very different. In the one here, you want to take that outside in, but you don't want, you make that apex late, you lose it right out to the wall as the banking dissipates. Then you get a little banking here, and it kind of flattens out in the center here. And then more banking, but man, that wall comes out quick.
Yeah, and that's the hot spot,
here.
Milty, is coming off of four. We've seen lots of guys just carry a little too much,
and
you get a wall smack there. And
see how the track dips down in one and two, and that can really upset the car there. You have to be mindful of not turning the wheel too much, not overdriving the entries, especially with this draft, which is considerable.
And we're also, what we're seeing here, Milty, is that 91 car of Kent Shea growing larger and larger in his rearview mirror. He went from just a little yellow dot to a quite large yellow car behind him. And looked like he had to get off the gas there. Had a great run on Ken. Ken really doing a great job here, Milty. Nice and consistent.
Well, you know, his name is spelled Skejai, and he's a Japanese American, and you know, when we like to call him Skiji because that's what it seems like, you know. But Shay is how it's pronounced, and Jay is how he rolls, man. He's a fantastic man and a fantastic driver, and he knows how to get it done. And you don't see him a lot. You know, you haven't seen him in some of these broadcasts, but when he shows up, he's ready for business, let me tell you.
Absolutely. Looking at the speeds here, Milty, going into 3 and 4, carrying well over 180 miles an hour here on a mile and a half, Milty. That's really fast. And you can see here the cars are really mixing it up in front of Ken. And
a little bit of curb there. For Dennis Balsar.
We can see the field looking, coming back to
the top five here.
And with Ken Shea behind Ken Hansen, who we're riding with, he's really pushing Ken here. And you can see the lap times, Milty, from Ken's best to the current. There is some wear and tear on these tires.
Ken Hansen spins.
And there's a wreck behind him.
He goes around.
Yeah, and heavy contact there. And caution is out. Wow.
Well, you saw the tire dig from the 9 in car. How he missed a couple corners there. And he was struggling. And the 21 was struggling in front of him, Dennis Balsar.
This
is for real here, man. Excuse my language. And that's a hard leg for Ken Shea.
And we're in car with Ken. You can see he's having a lot of problems. Maybe some flat tires, Milty. It's hard to get that car going.
And then up against the wall getting going again there. Wow.
Yeah, and just a very uncharacteristic mistake there, it looked like, from Ken Shea. Let's take a look at it from the outside.
Oh, well, this is pro racing. These sets are hard to drive, and they're fast and loose, as, Motorhead would say. Because I like it fast and loose.
We can see the 91 there following the 9 of Ken Hansen, who we were riding with there.
When your tires start to wear, you start to get oversteer. And then
Milty, he may have had just a bit of help there.
Yep. That's Pops Markson getting in the back of him a little bit there.
And then Troy Higgins in a 19 had nowhere to go as they collided and got into the back of the 99 car.
Ay caramba.
Yeah. And then I think Ken may have had... Oh, and then he got hit by the 007, Milty, as he was sliding down the track trying to get the car righted.
Oh!
And that's a bad that's a bad break for Dan there.
Well, guys have to race back to the line, but you also have to slow down. Bad all the way around.
Yeah, it's bad all the way around. Bad break for Dan there. I'm sure he didn't think that he needed to slow down so later in the incident, but as Ken's car may have had a flat tire.
You can see that banking there.
Yeah, the banking and a possible flat tire were working against him at the same time.
Well, you and I both know how tough it is to race with these guys, how hard and how skilled they are, and looking forward to tomorrow's... we got a little race we're going to be running tomorrow.
Yeah, it starts at, 5:30 Pacific for us, Milty, and ends about the same time.
12 hours of Sebring,
12 hours later, we'll throw a checkered flag. And, I'll be leading off car number one tomorrow, so.
I'm not even sure what car I'm in. After this broadcast, I got to get dialed in on a few things, and then I need to get some dinner and get some sleep, because I'm going to have to be up early, too, and get her done.
Absolutely. Yeah, we're going to shake down a little tonight and then get a good night's sleep, and I'll be up and at 'em well before the sun comes up here, Milty.
At 12 hours,
landing, we're riding a Corvette.
Is this going to be your first start in a car?
No, I've started other endurance races. Maybe the first start in a Corvette. But yeah, it's Sebring. Anyone familiar with Sebring, it's tough.
My dad used to say, my dad said 12 hours at Sebring was way harder than 24 hours at Le Mans. And he did Sebring 5 times and Le Mans 3, so.
Yeah, so that's good perspective there. And it is. It's obviously a sim, but if anything is to be felt through your steering wheel, it's at Sebring as you battle the elements there. And then probably a 45-50 car field, Milty, mixed class racing. So it's going to be a challenge. And you lose your focus for 1 second of 12 hours and your race could end.
Yeah, World War II Air Force Base, runways connected by
The taxiways and the little access roads of the airport, and then some runway action, and put it all together and you got a very demanding track that's just a classic road racing track in America. And we're ready to go to a classic oval here back to Charlotte. 32 of 140 done. Jeff Hale still holding court in the lead here.
What a great week he's had. It's what a great week he's had. FSB did it on the 500, which DRTV did a fantastic job. They had technical difficulties, and they're going to give us another broadcast for free, which is really cool of them. And of course, we have us, and we also have Mark Dillon and PE Broadcasting. We're very lucky to have all these great people involved in
caution
in our sim racing.
Excuse me, as there's a big wreck here with Leo and Dan Jones, and looks like Dan also involved in that. Caution is out again, so we'll be slowing down.
Well, as you watch these cars go by, take a look at the layout of this track. It's so bizarre, but so cool. I mean, the words, I'm not even explaining right, but take a look at like the restarts, the banking on the restarts, the different changes in the angle of the pavement, the lines these guys have to take at 180 miles an hour. Coal tires is so challenging.
That's one thing that you just have to.
Yeah, looks like Leo just spun not to make contact there. That was looks like Jeff Havoc and Ken Shea in front there.
Yeah,
it looks like
Jeff's car got out of shape ahead of Ken Shea, and Ken hard again into the wall. Boy.
And Ken damaged already, so. Yeah.
And Dan and Leo just went for a ride there, it looked like.
Oh, bam. Oh, and it was that Reaper, somebody hard into the wall, trying to avoid that. Going to narrow this field down.
Yeah.
For sure.
And the other dreaded saying in NASCAR is cautions, breed cautions, Milty, as the field stays bunched and guys sometimes feel the best time to make up a position is in those first couple laps when they have brand new tires and everyone is tight together where they can grab a couple positions. And sometimes this happens when someone gets out of shape ahead of you and you're racing so hard so soon, it's hard to get out of the way of them.
Well, racing ebbs and flows. We've had long green flag runs. In some of our races here recently and tonight, early, we've had total confusion with all the stuff that's gone on. But there's no confusion up front with these guys. Pisconer, Ryan Johnson, Rick Johnson, and the leaders up front, Josh Elliker. These guys are dialed in, man. I mean, it would be, you know, I'd like before the end of the season to get out there in one of these broadcasts and on one of these ovals and just, you know, show the people what it's like, because I bet you I'd be in the back. You know, I got lots of words, lots of mouth, lots of, you know, blah, 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 but, you know, but you bring it in brass tacks, can't relate to how good these guys are, especially up in the front. The regular, every week, these guys are running good there. There's no smoke and mirrors, man. It's skill that pays the bills. And, you know, I'd love to get out there before this end of the season. I'd like to get out there and bring the old Trojan Condom Chevrolet out there and you know, give it a run and broadcast from the car, you know, and say, you know, see what happens. But I bet you, you know, I'll be, you know, it'd be tough to compete with these guys, how good they are. You know, easy to sit here in the booth and say what you should have, could have, would have. But these guys are the real deal, man.
You said it. And slowly going through the field here. So you take a look at all the various paint jobs these guys do. Nice work by, as you said, many great painters here at FSB.
Well, it's still early here. It's hard to, you know, foresee fuel mileage, but, you know, you're looking at probably 36 laps. Eventually, you're going to go green here. These drivers, every time they make these stops and come out, they're going to thinking about, you know, if it goes green, you know. Best and worst case scenarios involved.
And as we go back to the FSB pace car, Milty, lights are off. So we'll be going back to green flag racing momentarily.
Well, and you know, too, and, you know, all the stuff you've done in the sports car stuff and you've run it in at this level, you also can feel what's about to go on here.
Yeah, you hope that as a group of drivers, knowing that there's been cautions now, Milty, that they're all thinking the same thing. Let's give each other room. Let's get the tires heated up. Let's log some laps, and let's decide it on the track and not, you know, a stop and start thing. And we still have over 100 laps to go, Milty, so still plenty of time here.
That guy in the 29, he knows one thing, and that's put the pedal to the metal. He's got the brains, the skill, and the moxie to make it happen, and he has no fear. And when you race against that 29 car, let me tell you, you don't want to see him behind you, because you know he.
Yeah, he's a hard.
Especially on cold tires, he's just a shizzle, you know.
Yeah, he's a get to the front mentality kind of guy. That's where he feels most comfortable. Some guys are comfortable riding around.
Oh, when you're that fast, why wouldn't you be, you know?
And some guys, you know, want to be the leader and want to lead laps. And he likes sitting on the, you know, he likes always qualifying. He always is there with, you know, a top three, top five minimum effort So that's his mentality. And some guys, you know, like let's say Slim, for instance, isn't so concerned about, you know, leading every lap and being the fastest car every lap. But Jeff is, and he does. And Josh Elliker, though, Milty, has just had a
Right up against the wall. He might have scraped the wall a little bit, and this is Charlotte, man. I mean, y'all are watching this, and the sim racers. You know how tough this track is.
Yeah, and side by side racing here just does not really work in the corners, and they stay side by side, and that's given Ryan Johnson and Rick Bisconner now a chance to catch right back up, and they're right on their heels as they continue to battle side by side through the quad oval.
Bisconner, after his great run, you know, he's hooked up with Slim Sim Racing. What a meteoric rise in his career, and what a fantastic run in the FSB Daytona 500. Come up short where he wanted to be, which was P1, but he was P3, and once again he's got Ryan Johnson in front of him. Except Ryan is not pushing his son. It's fair gratis here, and I think Rick would like to. You know, get past that 59 car.
And I think Jeff and Josh here are really battling hard for the lead here, Milty. Not a lot of give and take amongst the teammates here. And finally, Jeff reassumes the lead. And all that did was just bring everyone back to the front here, Milty.
Yeah, absolutely. This is not a track that you can just kind of lay about and let some laps go by, and then you, I think Rick, you know, once again, you look at the great one, Rick Johnson, sitting in 6th, 7th, 8th place there. He's doing what I wish I could do, you know. I mean, that would be what I would want to do. You know, he can flip that switch. But he's watching these guys push and waiting for that green flag run. And then he's going to show what he's all about. And we already know what he's all about.
Yeah,
leading the points and multiple champion in multiple divisions in this league. And he just has a knack for that. You can't, I don't know how to describe it, man. You just can't. That waylay where you just lay back and then you can press that go button, that extra turbo button, and you know there's no turbo in NASCAR 2003, but that guy has it, man, and you better watch out for that 52.
Yeah, and a little side by side action there amongst the 19 and 151, Troy Higgins. Getting the better of that early battle there as we look about the middle of the field here. There's Rick Johnson with a nice little bubble around him. No one really on his back bumper. And he's got a little gap ahead to Dennis Balsar in that 21 car. And then the third member of Slim Sim Racing, Rick Bisconner, Milty. So Slim Sim... three of the top four positions, Milty, with an injured boss man being Slim Jim Gately there, limping around toward the back of this lead lap cars.
Well, he will be supporting and working with his teammates. They have great team chemistry and great skill from top to bottom, and that's why Bisconner is just, you've seen the evolution of the 43. You see Troy Higgins here really taking a look here.
Man, Troy.
In the 19.
Troy is really, you know, for someone who isn't, like you say, an everyday, day in, day out, every series driver like Troy, when he shows up, Milty, he's so sharp. And it's so hard to do. And that's really impressive. And Yeah, he's giving Rick
he's got
Rick
skills to pay
right
the
now.
Bills, man.
And
he does it totally so clean, and he's just a smart guy, and he's dogging the 52, and that's
he's really working him over. And
let's see what the master does with this, you know.
Back up toward the front here, we saw Rick was pressing Josh Elliker for that second position. Now that's settled a little, and they get back in line here as this field kind of strings out, and everyone's still kind of in contact here. Jeff Hale established a lead. Milty shot out of the cannon on that restart, but since then, he's kind of just maintained that. He hasn't been able to drive away from anyone. Josh Elliker right on his back bumper this whole time. And Rick and Ryan now swapping positions.
How about that 43? And, holy cow.
And now we have Slim occupying the top
guy?
Three. So I'm sure
you know what?
Daddy Slim would be proud right
he's
now.
He's becoming a stud here. How about that guy pitcher and that Delby Cobra? He's falling back a little bit now, battling Hanson there, but he's got the 12 hours of Sebring looming here.
He's
going to be our teammate. And he's looking really strong.
Though, so he's doing what he needs to do early on in this race. And that's latch on to the lead pack. And he can probably see Rick Johnson there just glimpsing a couple cars ahead of him. If he can keep Rick in his sights, Milty, he'll be doing okay.
007, car seems to be pushing a little bit.
Yeah, he
with that outside line. He's just fighting to stay on this tail end, but, you know, definitely the 151, the guy pitcher is, you know, he's looking good right here. He's looking at a possible top five finish here, and he's definitely capable of that.
And these 43 and 59 continue to exchange blows. But right now, Rick has that position in third, Josh second, Jeff Hale still our leader. And as we hit lap 54 now, crossing about 20 laps or so in Milty into this run now. So what's the thinking if you're one of these front runners?
Well, I think you're going to take it up to about 34, 36, so they got a ways to go. Let's look at the last lap versus fast lap for these leaders.
Yeah, we see
FAL
Ryan very
last,
fast still.
Last lap, 39. Best lap, 37. So they're still in their wheelhouse tire-wise. Tire digs going to start to happen here pretty quick, though.
The 21 got a little loose, Milty, on the pass there. And now it's opened up a little gap now amongst the leaders. The 21 went down there to make a move and got a little loose.
You can catch that apron a little bit or you miss your apex point. That's all it takes for these pro drivers.
Yeah, and Troy Higgins has taken advantage. Now Rick Johnson trying to take advantage of that, Milty. And like you said,
so
one mistake.
Hard.
And now Dennis looking from like a top five to... battling for a top 10 now.
Choo-choo! That freight train's coming.
And they're still lined up there with Rick Johnson and now Ken Hansen and Guy Petra looking also to go through that window. Dennis doesn't want to have anything to do with it, and he slams the door on the 9 car nicely and gets a little loose again. A little lawn mowing there as Ken and Jeff Stone laps down.
Traffic.
Wow.
Oh, into the... Holy cow.
Wow, and that was some frantic racing there in the back of the pack as it looked like Ken bounced off Jeff Stone there, Milty.
A little bit of lawn mowing going on there, too.
As Dennis was mowing the lawn there, there was some door-to-door contact, too. So lots going on in the back of the pack.
I just like this guy BSing with him after the races, his attitude, his respect for the league, and the way he's run on the track. He hasn't gotten those wins you would love to get, but everybody loves a winner, but it's like, and you love yourself when you win, but the thing is how do you perceive how you run in a professional sim racing league, and the fact that he's so respectful with the fact that BSing with him after the race, and he's just glad to be a part of it and being able to compete with these great drivers. You just love to hear that, as these leaders are making a little bit of hay and making the gap between third and fourth place here.
Yeah, they are, Milty, and we're getting close to around 30 laps here on these tires now, so let's keep an eye
looking at the Ryan Johnson pit, the 59 is going to pit.
And we saw Ryan kind of heading backwards, Milty. He was battling. Oh, and there's contact with Ken Hansen from behind, Milty.
And these leaders don't want to.
And now the caution will come out, I'm sure.
Ken got loose and did not see or understand that Ryan was pitting, and Ryan was slowing down, and Ken got in the back of him hard.
Yeah, he sure did, Milty. And, that's...
Just like, the troubles for the 9-team Coors 4 team continue, and...
Yeah.
And obviously, that's not what he wanted, but, folks, when you're driving and you're trying to see these chats on... he missed that one, and we were just getting ready to talk about how hard pit road entry is here, and when guys go to pit, Ryan definitely posted several times there, but in the heat of battle, you're looking up and you see that chat, and the thing was, Ken got loose before he even got to the 59, and he obviously he'd like to take that back,
Well, we saw the damage there to the back of the 59 car, Milty, and it's quite significant. The 9 car, on the other hand, front end does not look that visually worse for wear, but engine damage could be a possibility anytime you hit that front end of these cars, Milty.
Yeah.
So that's another thing to look at. We see Ryan in his pit now, finally. As the leaders leave, he'll stay. And I'm sure the crew will be busily working on this car, trying to get it right now.
Yeah, tough luck for Ryan Johnson. Signals first, pits first. And
you can see
up there in the top
car,
five. Right? It's that's his chance for a win is the joy of his sim racing career probably was this weekend here in the FSB Daytona 500, pushing his son Isaac, young 16-year-old son, to the win in the Daytona 500, FSB Daytona 500, broadcast by DRTV. What an event, what a broadcast. They had some technical difficulties, but as sim racing goes, as you've seen tonight, But, he was tempered in how he talked, but I as a proud parent of my daughter, and what she does in life, I know he was extremely proud, and to be able to do that, sitting side by side together, sim racing, your son next to you, and you want to lead a good example, and you want to and his son is trying to make a real career in racing, go-kart racing and stuff, but glad that we could be a small little part of watching what happened that afternoon, and But tonight, it's not going to be in this. It's not going to be his night, you know.
Yeah, yeah, that guy. We saw the work done on the car. There,
we like to talk about Mark DeCinza as Mama, there goes that man. But, you know, like if you watch basketball, but Mama, there goes that 52. And there he is up in P3 here. Because I'm going to step away a minute and... sponsored by Budweiser, the king of beers. I'll be right back.
And as the lights go out on the pace car, so we'll get back to green flag racing here. Lap 65 of 140, so closing in on the halfway point of the race. As we saw right as that caution came out there, Ryan Johnson, the 59 car, was coming into the pits on a green flag stop. And that was just about maybe 31, 32 laps. So keep that in mind as we go back green. That would be about, let's say, 95, 96, 97. Obviously, can you get to like 105? Can they do four? Can you do a 40-lap run? I don't think you can. So if that's the case, this may be one of those break it down from the last lap going backwards to this lap kind of situation here with about 75 laps to go. Can you do, you know, 37 laps? Maybe. Probably not. So then you have to reassess again. Can I clutch and save? Etc. Etc. These are all things that these are going to be running through the drivers' heads here. As the pace car pulls off, Jeff Hale still solidly our leader here. Great run by Jeff so far. And we'll watch these cars come down to us as the green flag flies, and they come into turn one here. Rick Johnson up to third now. Rick Bisconner fourth. Troy Higgins fifth. Guy Petra sixth. Dennis Balsar in that 21. Sitko seventh. Ken Hansen, Slim Jim, Ken Shea. So these are some cars that are been banged up a little, and you can see the back end of Ken Shea's car. Looks like someone did a wrecking ball on it, but you know, with the skill of his driving ability, he can keep that car relevant in a draft probably. And right now he's probably driving it for all it's worth, trying to hang on to a top 10 finish. And there we see Guy Petra going up just a bit high there, and that might cost him a position as Dennis gets around him, and now Ken Hansen and Slim Jim looking to go around him. So early on with these cold tires, sometimes you drive it into these corners and the car just wants to go right up against the wall there. Got a lift to save it, and that's when the guys behind you can really take advantage of it. This looks like guys right in shipping, and I think Slim's car is just off from the damage. He just cannot do what he normally... Oh, and there's contact between him and Ken Shea, and Slim goes spinning. And Ken Soska also involved. And Slim now sliding all the way down to the inside wall by pit lane. And the caution is out. And again, it was just no real estate coming off of that turn there. And we'll take one quick look at that. And it just looked like they just ran out of room there. Ken Shea had a much faster car, it appeared. And as they came off the turn, it looked like the 91 just kind of pushed up. And just ever so slight contact with him and Slim. But that bounced Slim off the wall. And then he caught the 07 car, who did a great job right there of avoiding Slim. at the expense of his own spin out there. So
a little contact there, but didn't be too much for the 07. But hey, man, when it rains it pours, definitely not Slim's night, man.
Yeah, it's just not been Slim's night, or nor Ken Shea's, Milky. Jeez.
Yeah, that's racing. These guys are ultimate pros.
And we see the 91 retired. That could have been a possible second ink as well, Milty.
Yeah, he was mindful of that, and you know, tough luck, you know. But like a pro, and mindful of the rules. That's a good job by Ken Shea.
Yeah. Our leaders come down pit lane, Milty, just past the halfway point of the race. So we have about, let's say, 65 laps to go, Milty. You're just basically one full fuel run, and you should be able to make it to the end.
Absolutely, yeah. And you know, now we got to start focusing on these leaders. You know, been a lot of action through and a lot of yada yada here, but these guys are. Now what's going to happen here? Elliker, he's just always up in the front. Like four or five poles for him already this year. And even when he doesn't pole, he's right by the pole. And he is all over it like the shizzle here.
And this is where he's at his best, in my opinion, or on these one and a halves.
Absolutely.
He just really shows his strength. Las Vegas, Kentucky, Homestead, those type tracks, Milty. He's just so smooth, and he can really keep the speed up through a whole run, where some guys might be fast in, you know, 5-10 laps of the run and then they fall off. He's very consistent, and of course, as you said, being on Slim Sim Racing doesn't hurt.
Well, this year you have to look at that as being the marquee team. There's always that stud team every year that rises to the, you know, the signings they made this year. It's brutal for the competition here. Rick Johnson's not thinking about team points there. He's thinking about World Championship, another one under his belt, and they're going, what's that 52 going to do, you know? And I would be.
Yeah.
It's like, and that guy just pulls a rabbit out of his hat like you wouldn't believe, and you don't want to see him in your mirror, you know? Mild-mannered, soft-spoken guy, respectful. He does his talking on the track, and like all these guys, you know, but you know, being a teammate and a nemesis of his, you know, just could never hate the guy because he's so cool, you know. He's just someone you want to hang out with, and but you know, then he kicks your butt, you know. So what you gonna do here?
We see Ryan, who led a couple laps under caution there, peel off to pit lane.
Yeah, they're going for team points, you know, and he got damage, and he's going to pick up at the rear of the field. Tough luck for Ryan. Great run tonight, and pretty much great week for him, you know. With the, you know, how could it not be pushing your son to the win in the FSB Daytona 500? Kind of all cool from there, you know. Next week, though, they'll probably forget about that and start thinking, you know, I need to get a win here myself. But he's probably still riding on that high, you know.
The lights are now off on the pace car. Back green flag racing with about 67 to go, so if we can stay green here, we may just see one more stop.
Yeah, you're right on the edge here, fuel-wise. They're clutching.
Of course,
you
Ryan
see them
now
clutching and under caution.
And Ryan, with the only one coming in late of the lead lap cars, certainly would feel he has enough fuel. So we'll see if that plays out, if we can stay green here as the pace car pulls off down pit lane and we're ready to get back racing.
That rear damage will be a handful, though. It's hard to overcome that. That and the draft of these leaders. The only chance you have is if they can't make it on fuel. Oh, somebody gets the wall
Dennis there. Was a little
the guy
up
Pitcher
the wall.
Way down low. Nice evasive action from the 151.
Yeah, the 21 got a little loose, Milty, and then as he was catching it, bounced off the outside wall and had everyone scramble around him. But looks like no harm, no foul. Stay green. Jeff Hale continues to be our leader. Josh Elliker, Rick Johnson, Rick Piskonard, and Troy Higgins. And now Ken Hansen, Milty. Can he shake off the past earlier incident there and come back with maybe a top five or beyond here? He's looking pretty good, and the car looks okay.
Well, the fans are rooting for it because he's done a great job in the midst of having disappointment. Been a great sportsman and also a great asset to the league with setups, and he's done a lot of work in that area, and man, you just got to root for the guy, you know. I mean, Rick Johnson is starting to get things going here, but Troy Higgins says, I don't think so. I'm
going to
make that move.
And Rick up very high there, almost had a little brush with the wall there. So Rick, I believe, is going into a little conservation mode here as he lets many cars by him.
Well, once you get out there, you're kind of a pawn, you know, and got to go with it. But there's always a master plan with the 52, so we shall see here. Hey, he's smelling, you know, I think he's smelling, you know, a possible green flag run here, and we know what he can do with tire wear. He's leading the points. He's a champion. Just like myself, you know, like Grand Touring Prototypes on Sunday, you know, when I raced against the great Doug Tivik, there are tracks where I can't, you know, there's just no Laguna this week, last week. He was the man, you know. I had to back it off and just try to get second, and you know, I got the points lead, and you know, race like a champion. Sometimes you gotta, you know, it's all about winning the championship, you know.
Absolutely. It's at the end of the year, who's going to hold the trophy here? And, of course, Jeff Hale wants to maybe hoist that trophy again. He's missed the race, though, so he's going to have his work cut out for him.
Yeah, for him, it's if he wants to win that championship, he's got to win. So it's, but he's got the skill to do that. And every track.
Oh, and Ken
Lee. They're crashing behind.
And there's contact with Rick. And he's slowly into the wall there. Not too bad. But he got loose right before that, Milty. And I think Rick just couldn't.
I think Piscotter just got a little. I think he should be okay in that 43 car. What a wonderful paint job for that 43 car. But, oh my gosh, man. Ken Hansen, you know, I mean, just he's guys are so good. These guys are on the edge all the time.
Yeah, and you can see Ken loose there, and then there's contact with the 43. Yeah, not a lot of contact there as Ken spun through the grass and then all the way across the track and into the outside wall.
Yeah, a little love tap after Hansen got loose there.
So
that's the curse of death coming out of turn four, is that when the car starts to get tight coming out and then you overcorrect, it looks like he just overcorrected that steering and to dive it back in because he didn't want to give up that spot. And these guys are going to come in and get four tires. There's no bones about it.
Yeah, you still can't go the rest of the way, so everyone's going to have to stop again. And Rick Johnson missing his pit there, Melty, had to back up. That may cost
getting around.
Look like Risconner with a two-tire change. He gets out ahead of everyone. Then Jeff Hale and Josh Elliker and Troy Higgins. Then Rick Johnson, I believe.
Wow.
Rick actually losing many positions there.
I don't know about that, man. That's great track position, but these guys are going to gobble them up like a fish on a string right here.
Yeah, a bold move by Rick. But Rick Johnson having some issues there, Milty, and
he lost
some track position.
That's rare from the champ here. When you have to go around a car like he did, and folks, you know, if you haven't sim raced, you know, it's one thing when you can slide into your stall with a clean. It's hard enough to hit your marks. You got to go pit road speed here is, I believe, 45 miles an hour, or is it 55? No, it's 55 here, but you got to. When you can slide in your stall, it's one thing. When you got to go around the car and then get that angle, man, it is so tough. You take it for granted what these guys are doing, and it looks like child's play. It's not. You know, it's very difficult.
It very much is. In Charlotte, very traditional track, Milty. The pit stalls are not gigantic either, so... when everyone's coming down pit lane, it's very busy, very tight. And, Rick just overshot it, had a backup.
Just a hair,
just that slight mistake cost him, like, four positions.
You gotta back it up, and then sometimes, even if you back it up, you had to back it up and go forward a couple times, but... He's on the lead lap, not too bad, still looking at a possible long green flag run here now, and he can turn the jets on now. He's leading the championship points here, so he's going to be mindful of that, and he knows how to win championships, and that's by not getting excited when things go bad, you know.
And obviously, not really needing a win to make anything significantly different in the points. If now it's all about maintenance and getting the best finish possible right now.
To these three guys up in front here, Higgs and Josh Elliker and Jeff Hale, they want to win real bad. And how about Balsar up there? He's got a little bit of damage, scraped the wall, but a fantastic run for him. Ken Soska, the admin, what can you say about the 07 except class act? Just improving his craft every week in this type of racing and road racing. And great friend, you know, you just kind of root for this guy, and in that Darrell Waltrip Gatorade Chevrolet. He's not done yet, but he's got a little bit of damage too. I think he got a little bit of nicks and bruises.
Yeah, he may.
Just got punched in the, you know, in the nose, but he wiped it off, you know. So we'll see what he got, you know. But I would love to see him in the top three because, what a great guy he is, you know.
And we'll have 55 to go, Milty. So,
but you got Secretariat and you know, you got the studs in front of you. So good luck with that.
And he's got Rick Johnson behind him, so we'll have to drive both.
You got Man of War. You got Triple Crown winners in front of you.
Jeff Hale
with those restarts are he's brutal if he's behind you, but when he's in front, he just knows one thing and that's go, and he just does not falter. I mean, on those restarts, these guys are pros, man, and he's just smoking them like a train right here.
Yeah, Jeff off to another great restart there. Josh Elliker, Troy Higgins, desperately trying to stay with him right now. 21 of Dennis Balsar as well, looking pretty good right now. Staying with that lead pack.
He may have dodged the bullet with that cosmetic damage, the Sicko 21 Ford team. And he would love to get on the podium, and very humble, very... he's just done everything right, and that's as a fan, I would just love to see this guy get up there. Come on.
And right behind him, those 07 and 52, Ken Soska, Rick Johnson. Then a little gap back to the 151 guy, Petra.
Here comes Troy Higgins.
Guy running in 7th, and there's a move by the 19 car getting around the 47. So Troy Higgins up to 2nd. Breaking up that Slim Sim 1-2 punch.
Oh, you know how hard that is, man. Well, you know. Fans, it's hard.
Rick and Ken side by side. Oh, and Guy a little...
Guy Petra into the wall.
The car looked like it just pushed right up. Maybe carrying just a tick too much speed there, Milty. And he bounced off the outside wall.
That's a pretty good leg for the 151 there. Carroll Shelby's not going to be happy with that. I wouldn't be standing here telling you that. He's going to need that Z-Max to keep that car going. Man.
And Rick was able to get around Ken there, so now Rick up to the 5th position, Milty. Rick Bisconner right there as well. Now, remember, Rick might have a little damage to the car as well. We don't know. But Troy Higgins now looking over to the 29 car. And, you know, if you're Troy, your car's really strong here, Milty. Do you press the issue here, or are you content?
Well, as a fan, watching this guy, I think he's a great late run kind of guy, and I think he's really going to put the pressure on the 29. The 29 knows one thing, and that's somebody's behind me. I don't want him to pass me, so we're gonna have to see if he makes a mistake and bobbles. Right now, he's been cleaning his glass and hasn't faltered in that Miller High Life.
No, he
car, and
he very rarely drives in the mirror, Milty. He usually is looking out.
He's looking forward.
In the lead, so, yeah, I don't think he's too concerned with what Troy Higgins is doing. I think he's worried about hitting his marks. But Troy has really strong car, and he's
there comes
really
Higgs down low, and he's gonna make that move.
And side by side
in the turn one.
And it's very difficult here.
Come on, son. Yeah. Get some.
Jeff is going to have that momentum of the higher line as well.
The grip is not as good up there. Though this is an aftermarket track, and see the scales of the 29.
Really hooked up on that outside.
That thing
run.
Is just, inside, outside, upside down. That car is a beast, and he is not giving that up.
No,
and
he's
you
not.
Don't, when you race that 29, let me tell you, that's exactly what you get.
Some great side-by-side action for the lead. Then Josh Elliker, Dennis Balsall, Rick Johnson.
This guy playing their favor.
Oh, absolutely. And there's contact.
A little bit of contact.
And oh, going into down the into grass. The grass. A little pass in the grass there by the 19 car.
Pass in the grass on the gas. That's your 19
and
is your leader.
I believe that happened almost in the same spot, too. As Troy muscles his way into the lead.
You
oh
don't
my.
Like this stuff, man. You better find something else to do, man.
Wow,
this,
what a bold move by the 19
right here,
car. And he just kept his foot down. Look at the cloud he's
oh,
left
car there. Around behind him.
And Ken Hansen's spinning, but don't think he was part of the original wreck there.
Caution is out. Ah, caramba.
Yeah, the caution is out. We see the pace car.
What about that action? Get some.
I don't know what happened.
Man, these guys are good.
Out the caution.
You believe damage on the 9? Probably. Let's take a look.
Yeah, no, let's see if we can find what the problem was. We see Ken Hansen spinning there, but it didn't look like the caution was already out when that happened, Milty.
What you going to do now? You still got to get four tires here. Got to get four.
And it just looked like Ken's car got loose, Milty.
Yep.
And we go back live because we don't want to miss this pit stop action here. As we see Jeff Hale, that first car in the shot, Rick Johnson behind him.
Rick Dale's a stop this time, but you lose some time going around that car. Oh, what's going to happen
Dennis
here?
Dennis had some problems as well. And looked like Rick nipped the 21 out because Dennis had some issues with Ken Soska with another tight pit situation there, Milty, as you said before. And that cost him a position.
Well, this stuff gets scrambled around. So then when not only do you have to, caution out, I got to come in. Then I got to remember, what's my track position now? Who's going to be in front of me, and how am I going to deal with that? You got to be Roger Penske and ex-driver, whoever you are, at the same time. You got to be pit crew, pit manager, and driver in this sim racing game.
Absolutely. Yeah, sometimes you're a really good driver, but maybe not such a good crew chief one day.
Yeah.
And then the next week, you have the right strategy, but you wrecked the car.
I'm raising my hand. some of the great wins I've had, I just, somehow I nailed it. But then all those defeats where I maybe had the best car, I blew chunks,
So we're still, I believe, outside the window for these guys. So now it's another dilemma situation for these guys. Do you chop this in half, Milty, and do a 20-lap run if it goes green? Or do you run the thing dry?
I think you got to look at who's still running right now and the damaged cars and the possibility. I think you got to assume there's going to be another caution. So you have to think, run it out and deal with it. Okay. I don't think you can ruin your track position right here.
Yeah, we should go green at
especially
about 40
for the
to go.
Leaders. If you're you know, we're looking at you know, 8-9 cars close to that. The rest are pretty much the cream of the crop, and that's it. So none of these guys can afford to. You know, if you get down close, you might take a chance, and but you know, I don't think so, man. I don't think so. Yeah.
I think if I'm one of the back tier guys, if I'm Slim, let's say, or Guy Petra, I may do a chop this in half and pit at lap 20.
Yeah.
And see what happens. If I'm Jeff Hale, I'm probably gonna run it out and get the least amount of fuel with no tires and do a 10-lap run.
Well, you're looking at still probably 39 laps before we go green. I don't think you can't make that. No, you're gonna have, like you said, you're gonna have to stop and let's say if you run 30, you're gonna have 9 laps to go. You're absolutely right. You'd be a no-tire stop, and or you can break it down a little bit and go 2 tires, and you're still looking at half a can to a splash.
Yeah, if you pit early, Milty, then maybe you can get away with a 2 tire and a half a can. And go on where maybe if you run it all the way, you might go with the splash, and you don't want to take those tires. So we'll see. And a lot of strategy still in play here. As we said, about 40 to go as we get the green flag again. Jeff Hale has been the perennial leader in this race. It's one of our longer races of the season, 140 laps, Milty. And he's just been rock solid at the front.
This time, Elliker, he's been sizing him up. He's been right there. This time, I don't think so. You're not getting away. And he's going to use that again if we get another start. But he's a pro and a stud. And he watched the 29 walk away many few times already, so... This time, you know, heck with that. I've been eyeballing your starts, and this time, I don't think so. And you see that.
There as they go down the back straight.
These guys behind, they're kind of, you know, no passing through the back straight, so they're pawns in the game. They're, you know, but these... Oh, and Higgs up, Troy Higgins up against the wall. That's obviously what Rick Johnson wants to see. And he smooths his way by right there.
Yeah, he does. And now he's up.
This guy is
right on the back cover of Josh Elliker. And he got a great run there. And he may challenge him for second here.
Here we go. Mama, there goes that man.
But Josh Elliker has an extremely fast car all night, Milty, and I don't think he's worried so much about Rick Johnson. I really don't. I think he feels if he runs his race, he's either going to win or he's going to finish second.
Well, you watch what we were just talking about, his evolution of watching these restarts, which are huge, and watching how Jeff Hale was hitting, where he was getting his restart. And he was not, wait a minute, here comes that 52 car.
It's a great side-by-side battle going on here.
That turbo button, he just hit it.
And Josh forced high there, and he's going to have to give ground. And that's going to leave Troy Higgins to get by as well and everyone else.
What a beautiful move.
Man, look what happens when you get shuffled, Milty. It just kills the momentum of
all of a sudden, you got that guy behind you. That guy.
And caution is out, though.
Caution is out. My gosh, you don't want that guy behind you. That red car behind you. You look in the mirror as Balsar and Guy Pitcher go around.
Yeah, let's take a quick look at that. Looked like some contact between the 59 and 21, Milty, and unfortunately Guy Pitcher was an innocent victim there. He took it into the grass. Really no contact at all. Just a spin into the grass there. I believe he took the caution as well. So he should be okay there.
What are you going to do now for these leaders? Just a couple laps here.
That's a reprieve for Josh Elliker too, Milty. He'll be able to gather his thoughts back in and maybe get four fresh
ones. Well, what's he going to do? Here they come. They're all coming in.
Yeah, I think you got to come in. There's still plenty of laps. Still 30.
Couple laps here, but I think you got to get four tires again.
Yeah, I think so.
This thing's a cheese grater, man. But they're all sniffing, going, what they going to do? This time, Rick Johnson gets a slide right into his stall. He's a little trouble for the 29. He had to back up just a hair.
Yeah, and it looked like Josh Elliker got the best of that exchange. So Josh trying to make up some positions.
Rick Johnson in the lead! The 52 of Rick Johnson nailed that. Once he didn't have to go around the 47, he slid in that stall. He'll get P1.
And Jeff.
Mama, there goes that man.
And Jeff will have to deal with a second place restart now with about 30 to go or so. With that further up pit stall, he nailed his pit stall. And that really helped him. He jumped up back up to third there. So, new life for the 47 car.
Ken Soska spinning it in the infield early. What a great run for him in P4. God, we'd love to see him on the podium.
And
see how it pans out. Piscotter back up and in the P5
like,
there.
Looks like Troy Higgins is maybe our loser of this pit exchange here, Milty. As he's going to come back in.
Along with
Rick and Guy Pitcher. Of course, Guy slid the car to avoid that wreck there, Milty. So definitely four fresh ones are in order for Guy.
A lap car there with heavy damage. That thing's beat up like a big dog. That'd be Jeffrey Stone. Right on the edge of the fuel window here. I still don't think that. I think if you clutched, you could make it from here. But these guys ain't clutching. They're going balls out. So
we're closing in on 30 to go right now, 34 to go. Light's still on. So clutching would definitely pay some dividends for you under caution, where you can really save a lot of fuel.
They'll all be doing
almost
that.
Almost impossible to do anything once the race starts, Milty. This is a very fast and demanding track. You really can't take it easy, or you'll get left behind quickly.
Yeah, you gotta have long green flag runs, and the leaders go back in, and Rick Johnson stays out. The leaders pull a snookerino on him, and they go back in to top off. Because they know this is the fuel window, like I was saying. This is right there, and Wow, that's usually Rick Johnson's forte there, but he gets snookered like a big dog, and or not, maybe they all went in together, so they just left him out to dry like a wet rag, and you gotta expect him to do that. Because they want to win this race, and what they're seeing is things are going to go back to green 109, 110, 110. That's going to be 30 laps. They think they can make it, and can Rick make it,
Well, if anyone can, Melty, it's a 52 car. Lights are now out on the pace car, so we will go back green with 32 to go.
Him and Soska, P1, P2, FAL, he's gonna be charging like a dog on fire, man.
Yeah, but Jeff also has to show some patience here with no passing to the backstretch, Milty.
Yes,
He
sir.
cannot
Yep.
just charge into the lead here as much as he may want to. He's going to have to bide his time somewhat and let these guys get going in front of him, and that's Rick Johnson and Ken Soska.
About the 07 there, man, rolling his dice, seeing what's going on there.
Absolutely.
Ken Soska is a relative newcomer compared to he's an admin at FSB, respected and a great friend, but he is also compared to these guys, they have huge experience in this arena compared to him, and he is come on, Ken.
He's not so good. He's
I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, I mean he's wrapped around a bunch of Michael Jordans right now.
and he's still hanging on to that second position. Jeff Hale nipping at his heels in third. Josh Elliker right there. Dennis Balsar, Troy Higgins. These guys are all fast, and they've all battled. And their 21 car loose. He had to save it, chase it all the way down to the apron there, but did a great job of doing it.
Rick and Ken Soska want to see that caution again, and then we'll make it on fuel, and they probably could still make it on fuel.
Jeff making a little
Rick
look there.
Johnson's he would have pitted if I really believe he would have pitted if he thought he couldn't make it.
I'm sure he would have, Melty. I'm pretty sure he thinks he can make it.
But they have fresher tires on him, but he has the air on the nose and the lead. And like I said, he can push that button and go from chilling to villain,
And Jeff Hale making the move again. He might make it stick this time.
This guy is not going to be
And he
denied.
did.
That 29 is going to go balls out. Hell bent for leather. Hell bent for leather.
And now Ken's gonna have his hands full with some hungry guys as
Oh
Josh
boy,
Elliker.
Josh Elliker on the apron.
Wow, great job by Rick
That
Pastrana
stole.
there and Troy Higgins,
Yeah,
but
for
it
not
cost him some
wrecking,
track position.
but yeah, Elker, what a great
Wow.
save there! But that definitely hurts them. And now we got a 3-hour show here. Not over yet. Lots of laps left. These
Wow.
guys are still in the draft. But what a great save and what a great
That car's still loose, Melty.
recognition! Once you get loose here. And you use hurt those tires.
Yeah, that's a big bonus for Ken Soska there in third, Milty.
Absolutely.
He was under fire there. That if
Come
he
on,
couldn't
kid.
hold those guys off, he may have went from third back to eighth or ninth position. But instead, with Josh's bobble there, he's held on to third now, and he's really latched on to Jeff Hale nicely. So those top three
absolutely
are there, but that second pack has re-caught them. So Josh and Troy and Ryan there are still very fast cars.
Soska was like the kid looking through the fence a couple years ago or a year ago. I wish I could be a part of this. And he put the work in, and he crawled through that fence and got in on the, and got to watch it, and got to, and then he got his ride, and what a meteoric rise. No matter what happens for the 07, you know, as a friend and as a driver, all the things he's done. He's
really under fire.
And like he's under Allison. Fire from these studs. But
and Josh really drives it in there hard.
Yeah.
Wow. And makes it stick this time. And he'll pat. And boy, that's earning a pass
and
right there by Josh.
And here comes Troy Higgins. But
and Ken having nothing to do with that, though.
You get passed and repassed. This time he shuts the door on Troy Higgins.
Yeah, he certainly did. Definitely took a different line there to make sure Troy knew. Don't think about the inside there, Troy. And he's hung on to Josh Elliker, and he's still right on his back.
That's what you need to do. You got to defend down low. And
maybe you can loosen him up and repay him.
You belong here, son. You've earned this place. Defend. Defend.
He's forcing Troy to go high.
Yeah, absolutely. Make his ass go high. That's what you got to do.
And Troy,
he's admin in this series.
And there looks like there might have been some contact there, just very little, but nonetheless, some door-to-door action there between the 07 and 19, and they're not pulling away as they battle.
Given room, great racing, still side by side for P5, P4, side by side again, and you got the 29 all over the 52.
And now we're
come on, folks. Is there any better than this or what?
There's
20 to go.
20 to go, and they're fighting like there's two to go.
That's the smell of this race.
And look at Troy Higgins' car on the outside, Milty. It has come alive, and he's made the pass.
That guy's a world-class pro right there, and he made the pass.
And he's looking to do it again on Josh Elliker even. Wow, he's really letting that car hang out now, Milty.
Look at this pack of drivers. They're in a slouch in this whole league, but definitely in a slouch in this group right here,
Jeff
man.
Hale making a look on the
These
inside
guys
there.
Are badass, man.
And Jeff Hale will take the lead, Milty.
Wow.
With a just
like
a,
nothing.
Yeah, and Rick really didn't fight him there.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, Jeff.
The class of the field all night. That 29 Miller High Life Chevrolet has been the stud. And
I think that's actually a DeLorean or something there, Milty.
No shit. Didn't know they had that in NASCAR, but they definitely got it in sim racing.
They have it in the Arrow 88 series.
It's a beautiful piece and a beautiful guy driving it. And good luck with that. Here comes Josh Elliker on the inside.
He'll take that man. And now Rick has have to fight for that third position with Troy Higgins.
Lots
now.
Of time left. Right up against the wall for the 52, but now he's left the door open for the Wolves. The Wolf Pack is coming. I would say he's probably starting to think, I need to close this door. then save tires, and then put a whooping on these guys at the end, but it's not going to happen because the choo-choo train's coming through. He's on the outside looking in.
Yeah, and it's solid cars onto his inside right now, Milty. And I'm sure he knows that. So he might be fighting a little extra hard here.
There comes Ken Soska, man, on the inside. Man, I mean, he's got to be shitting peat seeds right here. Excuse my language. And that means you're shaking like you're like a leaf on a tree, folks.
And
can't make it happen.
Yeah, Rick able to hold off that fight there momentarily as they come
tire
up.
Tire tank's going to be an issue here.
Coming
this
up on
goes
some lap
green.
Traffic as well, so we'll see how Jeff and company negotiate. Jeff Stone there going high, scraping the wall just a bit.
Great job by Jeff, trying to let him by. Even that ain't easy, folks, in professional sim racing. You and I both know about having to get lapped.
Yeah, and you can see that very loose coming off of four. Yeah,
especially with a damaged car. I mean, that piece is bent up like a big dog.
And now Jeff Hale really
he's racing for points. You know, I mean, he's got every right to run on the track there.
Now they're getting around Slim, who's down on horsepower after smacking the front of the car early on.
Not his night, but
Jeff Hale trying to pull away here, Melty.
And he is pulling away.
And now Rick Johnson.
Gosh darn, man. I mean, you don't know what this guy is like when he gets that bit between his teeth. He's such a stud, man. You're sitting there going, you got to be kidding me.
13
to
go.
This guy, he's got that much left? And coming up on 10 to go? And he's
can he make it now, Milty? Now
dissing
now,
you.
Now
fuel,
with running this hard at the front, and it was some furious racing going on for several laps amongst all the leaders. Did they hurt their fuel mileage?
But was he one of the ones that pitted before that? I think he did, you know. But Rick Johnson is the one that stayed out and got track position, and Ken Soska, they're the ones that are more worried about fuel, but nothing on the scanner except balls out racing right here. And that 29, last lap, 31.071, best lap, 36.50. But, you know, they got definitely tire wear, 10 to go.
Yeah, and he jumped out.
Still gapping their asses. Wow.
But Troy Higgins is cutting into that deficit now and pulling Rick Johnson along with him.
Well,
and now
Josh Elliker
is trying to come back as well.
And here comes F52 there. You know, 29, he knows that it's in his nature. As a driver, you size up your competition. You know what that 29 is going to do. He's going to go for that lead. These guys know that too. So now they're starting to bring that gap closer. They've been saving a little here. Did they save enough?
Rick Johnson got a great run there on Troy. He's going to try the outside. He got such a run there, Milty. He has no
but,
choice but to try
but
it.
But now
there.
He's got Elliker down low. What he really needs to do is make that pass down low like these guys are looking to set the 29 up for.
Wow. No,
that is
took advantage of that move. And
okay,
get
back in line now. See the 19s. Troy Higgins is going to set the 29's been out there on his own. He's using this stuff up. The pass is going to be down low. And look, Higgs down there in the 19. He's going to make that move, and we'll follow him. This is a perfect opportunity. Elliker looking down low. I don't think he want to. Okay, he's making that pass. So
man,
forget
Josh
that.
Is, Josh is
what
really,
the hell do I know? I would be trying to follow somebody through to get to the 29, but maybe the 19's falling off. But you see the 52 following through. He got beat early. Guy's a smart cookie. He's going to lay back, and
well,
we got lots of time.
Yeah,
Got time, though.
We do, but these laps are really clicking off quickly now. And he's going to have to get not around one car, Melty. He's going to have to get around two cars.
That 29 is going to falter again. Stay in line and draft up on him and then make the move together. Be disciplined right here.
Of course, we have teammates. Easy for me to say.
So blabbing from my seat here. These guys are going at it. Blatting. Here comes Rick Johnson. I got to go. And nope, can't Josh, make it work.
Yeah, Josh holds them off.
That's to the 29's advantage. And, man, has Jeff Hale had the best car tonight or what?
He certainly has. And Josh, of course, teammates with Josh Hale. So, no harm done here making Rick work as hard as he can to get around him.
Rick wants the 47 to go down low and work the 29, but they're teammates, so
yeah, that's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen. He's going to defend now.
Right, so Rick's going to have to find a way around the 47 very quickly, and it doesn't look like there's any way around him right now unless he's going to take an undue risk. And if you're Jeff Hale, here we go.
Here comes the 52.
He's going to have to make it stick here. It's tough.
He's got it.
Okay.
Plenty of time. Two to go. Gather it up. Defend low because you got the 19 coming down low.
And now.
Wow, that's good. That car down low, but you still got the 19 down low.
And Jeff can take a defensive posture now as the leader.
If you can, tire wear is an issue.
And if you're Jeff, you gotta keep that car on the white line here, Milty. You gotta force Rick Johnson around you on the outside.
Coming up on one to go.
And Jeff,
Rick set that corner up great to get a great run coming off. Backed it off.
Get the run down the backstretch. Jeff Hale covering the inside. And they're tight coming around three and four. Coming out of four.
Did that hurt Rick Johnson?
Oh, Josh out of shape.
Well, Elker, you don't have to make that move. That was a great job. And that is the last lap.
They've separated a little, so it's going to be either Rick or Jeff.
That hurt Rick Johnson, but he's still right there. You know Jeff's going to defend down low. It's going to hard to be passed.
He's going to have to earn it on the outside. He's going to have outside in here.
Great job by Jeff to make that track wide.
And he dives down low.
Oh, yeah.
And he'll take it by about a car and a half.
Oh, man. Wow, man. Well, what can you say about that?
Troy Higg third, Ken Soska fourth, and Josh tried to make a move maybe one lap too soon there, Milty. Didn't work, falls back to sixth.
Oh, you know, Higg's, man, what a run there, man. What a great finish.
What a thrilling finish there. I mean, that had it all there. Josh made a bold move, and Troy, taking evasive action, had to go into the grass a little there, pulled it off, and he'll take the third and final podium spot. But Jeff Hale is the story yet again with just a true dominating performance here at Charlotte. Despite that thrilling finish, he really was the class of the field.
He was all night, and Rick Johnson does what Rick Johnson do, and this wasn't enough tonight.
And,
how can you not love that finish?
Taking the car over the lane here.
What a great show by these pro drivers. Fantastic stuff. How can you not want to be a part of that? Come on.
Jeff Hale trying to find his way into victory lane here, Milty.
Not
as friendly as he was hoping for.
Yeah, you know, he's pretty excited.
Park
but
it right there, Jeff. There you go.
There he goes.
And there's our Charlotte Motor Speedway official winner, Jeff Hale.
Well, they didn't turn the lights on there. I don't understand, you know, what the heck they're doing there.
Rick Johnson second. Troy Higgins rounds out our podium. Ken Soska, Dennis Balsar round out our top five.
Yeah, great job, Dennis.
And all the way back to Slim Jim. So Slim Jim still salvages a top 10 finish, Milty, with really a wounded car since very
early on. Yeah.
That's a Donkey Bop award.
That's
winner.
A Donkey Bop award winner, definitely. Never give up, Donkey Bop.
And he'll round out our top five, and Jeff Stone also persevered and was rewarded with an 11th place finish with the points there. So nice job by Jeff keeping a tough car there on the track to the end. And that rounds out our running cars. So 19 car start, Milty, in a war of attrition, 11 finish. And Jeff Hale really just covered the field all night long.
He was the piece to beat, and he did not disappoint at the end there. With all that pressure, he does what he do, you know, and he's in victory lane.
Yeah, of course, with this race going very long, Milty, if we can quickly gather them up so we can send these boys to bed. It's almost closing in on midnight Eastern. And Milty will go gather up our finishers as quickly as we can. Jeff Hale, Rick Johnson, Troy Higgins. We'll get a quick word with each of them. And then we'll call it a night here. And definitely worth the wait, though, with a great finish. Jeff shot out the lead. Rick tried to wrest that lead from him. Was successful for a moment there. Then Jeff powered back around him. And Rick tried to save up a little and make one final push there and just didn't have enough to get around Jeff for the win there. But a great finish and very exciting side-by-side action all night long amongst leaders and top five cars. So we're gathered up our finishers here. So, Jeff, you might have caught the tail end of that there. Just really the class of the field all night, Jeff. He had an extremely strong car. Looked like it was really hooked up to the track there. Once you got around Rick there, I'm sure you knew he was going to make one more stab at you. So you did a great job there of managing the race and taking home the checkers. Congratulations.
Thanks, buddy. Yeah, I know. I went in top golf, Rick didn't top off, so I knew he was a little bit, you know, short on fuel than I was. And I was trying to run pretty hard to make him use up his fuel, but, you know, Rick's good enough to where he can save fuel and make it there to the end. Yeah, I had to throw a block there at the end. I hate to do that, but win's a win. And, fun race. Always love racing here at Charlotte. Good job, everybody. It's a lot of fun.
You know, that was class pro racing, and you had to do what you had to do. You were the class of the field, and you had to make him go around you. I mean, that was what you needed to do, and everybody did great to not wreck, but at the same time, you got to defend low. I mean, it was your spot to keep, and you earned it, and great job, man.
Thanks. Yeah, I was still debating on letting him have the low side because I love that high lane too. I could really get a good run coming off the bad side. I better block a little, give him the high side. Yeah, good run tonight, Rick. You too, Troy.
Yeah, thanks, Jeff. Good win, man. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah,
Rick, you You had some, what's up, man? You had some problems there early getting around Troy when you lost track position and missed your pit stall, but gathered up and you had a pretty tempered race there and you really pushed on the end there, but we were worried about your fuel. How close was it? What with fuel, you know, not pitting that last time?
Yeah, that last run there was showing splash pretty much the whole time. So I was kind of surprised that Jeff, he was kind of backing off with me, helping me save gas. So I kind of thank him for that. So I figured he could probably make it to the end because them guys topped off. But yeah, pretty much the whole race was just trying to set it up for the end with fuel. From like I'd say one lap 107 from there on, I was just trying to, you know, get the fuel mileage right because a caution would come out every time. So then finally, like 40 to go, I started running hard. Then a caution would come out again, so it became a fuel mileage race again.
yeah,
good job, Jeff.
Yeah, didn't really have a good ebb and flow to the race with the cautions. It kind of chopped up the race there where every strategy had to be reset after every caution. And yeah, that was a great battle there at the end, Rick, and always appreciate the show you put on for us. But this time it's Jeff, and last time it looks like you two like swapping the trophies here, so you don't build up too many on the shelf. So you know, collapse and all. We saw a couple of pictures of that trophy case, Rick. Man, you might need like a few more brackets on those shelves.
I can always build another shelf.
Yeah, he's a craftsman, you know. He's different capable.
He's gonna need a heavy duty shelf, man, to hold all those trophies. Troy, though, man, what a race!
Awesome.
Every position that you took there, you were battling side by side with someone. Pretty thrilling racing there, and I'm sure you're very satisfied with that third place finish.
Yeah, most definitely. That was a good race. Had a lot of cautions, but we mixed it up at the front pretty good there.
Yeah, I saw you trying to work that outside line there, Troy. Did you find that it, during certain points of a run you were able to work that outside more successfully than the inside?
Yeah, usually within about the first 10 laps on the tires. Came in pretty good, but then it kind of go there toward the end of the run there.
Points are up. Yeah, Higgs, what a great run. Your race ebbed and flowed, and you really had the battle there. And then at the end, you're making great moves. I really thought Rick Johnson had the mojo there for the end, but you proved me wrong, man. I mean, you really were able to work outside in and make a battle there. Just quite, you needed a couple more laps, and it might have been different, but fantastic run, P3.
Yeah, I appreciate it, Milt. Enjoy running with you guys. I don't get to run as much as I want to, but there's always some awesome races.
Yeah, whenever you show up, you're always on our, you know, we're always talking about you. And it's always good, so.
It's a good thing.
Yeah, and we see our points up. Rick has a comfortable 22-point lead over Josh Elliker. Slim Jim there with the wounded car did fight back for that 10th place finish, Milty, so he mitigated the damage a little, but still 49 markers back now. But then our racing gets tight with Ryan and Rick just 3 points apart, and then just 4 points separating 6th, 7th, and 8th with Jeff now jumping up two positions looking at that a top five now, Milty. So some really tight battles going, and this is only race 10 of 23. So still a lot of racing to go.
Well, you know, I have to apologize, and I got a pen right here. So, Rick asked me to throw a shout out to his girlfriend, and I forgot her name. So I'm gonna write it down right now, Rick.
That's all right. She wasn't listening tonight anyway.
Oh gosh.
Well, good. He was all worried for nothing.
Well, I was, you know, because I was like, man, I promised it, you know. Now, what's your name? Let me write it down here.
Bonnie,
all right.
Usually we have it on listening while I'm racing.
Yeah, so, I mean, I was like, gosh darn it, you know. Because, you know, nothing, you know, sim racer doesn't do anything if he don't have his woman behind him, you know. There's a lot of things we could do in life that are a lot worse than on Friday night than playing this little game. And believe me.
All right. So, an extended broadcast here with the difficulties on the server issue there, Melty. Topping up on about 2 hours of coverage here. So we're going to call it a night. Congrats to...
Yeah, and thanks again for what you guys do.
No problem. Appreciate
thanks, it. Thanks, Troy. Appreciate it.
I enjoy doing this more than I could enjoy driving with you guys because it would be a short night for me. So, no problem at all there. And congrats, Jeff, Rick, Troy.
Great show. Watch the broadcast. Absolutely.
Yeah, good run all. That was fun.
And, when you guys tomorrow, watch that, man.
Yeah, next week the boys are at Vegas, so that's another mile and a half. We'll be at Milty, and that's a Josh Ellis.
Gonna be badass.
Maybe we'll see Mike Sanders show up at his hometown track. I'm sure to
hometown boy.
Give these guys something to race for next week. So we'll catch you then. And again, FSBRacing.com, Winston Cup Friday nights, Pony Express broadcasting throughout the season. Check it out.